Welcome to the afternoon session. My name is Martin. I'm this year's spokesperson of the Max Planck PhDNet, which, so to say, provides a platform to organize such conference here, and also the career fair. And we wanted to take the opportunity also to present this network, how it's structured, and what activities are involved. And so I kind of titled this talk today was Max Planck PhDNet, Breaking the Enigma, because the Max Planck Society is also kind of an enigma. And as I guess many of you know, so Max Planck Society is distributed all over Germany and has even institutes outside of Germany. So there are two institutes for the history of art in Italy, one in Florence, one in Rome. Then there's also one institute in the Netherlands for psycholinguistics. And these 83 institutes are subdivided into three sections. And the smallest section, as you might guess, is the humanities section. And the larger ones are the biology and medicine and chemistry, physics, and technology. So, and this, our main task within Max Planck Society is, as a non-university research organization, to facilitate basic research. So, and this is quite exceptional also to other a non-university research organization as Leibniz and Fraunhofer, that we really focus on the most basic research. Yeah? And this is funded by the states and the federation, 50-50. So, and that's also why the institutes are distributed all over Germany, because, of course, every state also wants his share, its share of institutes. Okay, so how we try as PhDNet to solve this enigma? Yeah? So we are quite well organized. So we organize 5,000 doctoral researchers. So at a certain time point, there are like 5,000 doctoral researchers associated with Max Planck Society. And last year, we implemented new statutes that for the first time define the role of PhD representatives at each institute and who is eligible to vote for them or elect them and who can run for this election. So, and all these PhD representatives then meet. So this is here 6,000, because you can also count over the whole year and not at a certain time point, and since there's some fluctuation, there are more. So, and they, these PhD representatives that are elected at the institute then meet once a year. So, and this year will be the 15th time. So it's not so young anymore. It's like in the older teenage years. And we'll meet here in Berlin to discuss where to we want to develop the network further and how we can represent PhDs best. So, and also in the last year, for the first time, we established a new structure that we call regional PhDNet hubs. And they are actually quite active and also, as you see, distributed all over Germany. And so the latest picture I got is from Göttingen. They just did recently a barbecue, and in Göttingen, where was the former headquarters of the Max Planck Society, we have now 5 Max Planck Institutes. So it's quite a vibrant research area there. And so this is also something the PhDNet engages in. And at this general meeting, the PhD representatives then of each institute elect the board of the PhDNet. We call a steering group. And the steering group consists out of 6 members I will talk later about. And also, this is maybe quite important, at this annual meeting, the PhDNet also gets together in working groups. And one of these working groups organized this exceptional event here, the Visions in Science and the Career Fair. So this working group is called Scientific Event Group. And so the general meeting is also an opportunity to join such a work group and get active within the PhDNet. So this is the steering group of this year that was elected at the last general meeting. So we are also present at least half of the steering group. So Katja and Jurek are sitting there. So Katja is this year our general secretary. And since we implemented these new statutes last year, she's mainly taking care of that we implement these new statutes and have proper elections at all the institutes. And Jurek is one of the section representatives I was talking about before. So we want that the disciplinary diversity is represented also in the board. So we have a section representative for each section. And Roman is taking care of our budget. So the Max Planck Society gives us a budget so we can organize such an event here, and also other things I will talk later about. And yeah, so I try to head this group. And also in the beginning of this year, we put up a very precise agenda where we try to focus our work on. And so this can be summarized on four pillars. So one pillar is, of course, strengthening the network internally by implementing the new statutes, but also externally we are connecting with other doctoral research networks, for instance, in the Helmholtz Association, because they are quite similar to us. And we are also, of course, this is always a big debate, compensation guidelines. And this was once the reason also why the PhDNet was founded, because there was this big gap between stipends and contracts. And this is one of the solved enigmas, because there was a big reform last year, and now all the new doctoral researchers will be employed via contracts. So, and of course, the PhDNet is one of the stakeholders that was pushing this change. And one of the very important topics this year is equal opportunity. So we have a quite active working group in this field. So and this working group tries to push forward diversity management within the Max Planck Society. So because there are implicit biases, as you know in science, that we are, for instance, lose many women on the way to a professorship. And but also other minorities. And so we want to take care of that we keep this diversity and not end up with only dominant male researchers at the end. And another big topic are career perspectives, and that's why we are organizing this career fair. We're putting a lot of effort in this, and also try to this year to diversify the portfolio of companies. That's why we, for instance, try to get the Bundesnachrichtendienst, which is the Federal Intelligence Service, and also the Foreign Ministry. And yeah, so, and I really like this term. I was this year at the annual conference of Eurodoc, which is on the European level, the platform where doctoral researchers meet. And at the European Commission, they call this bidirectional intersectoral mobility. Yeah? Because, I mean, the idea with our career fair is not only to smoothen the transfer from academia to industry, but also to strengthen our non-academic network. Because the idea is also that people working in industry then will go back once to research. Yeah? And there are cases for this, that, for instance, companies then give their employees maybe 2 years to join a working group to learn like the latest developments and then come back to their company. Yeah. So, how do we riddle? So we do representation internally and externally. We try really to push and improve doctoral training conditions. And this is mainly discussed, so the agenda, in our general meeting. We provide training, like a large fraction of our budget is used for soft skill seminars, where all doctoral researchers affiliated with Max Planck Society can apply for. So if they have an idea for a soft skill course that is not available, they can apply. We are the steering group to organize such a soft skill seminar. Then we do the Visions in Science and the Career Fair. And we do a lot of networking. For instance, there was like just a couple of weeks ago here at this venue a symposium for alumni and early career researchers, because Max Planck Society wants to push forward its alumni affairs, and we of course as we organize all the doctoral researchers. We are the link to, so to say, for the alumni. Yeah, and we also once a year meet the president, where we, for instance, this year then afterwards set up two working groups, one for career service and one for equal opportunities. And so the idea obviously there is to bring many stakeholders as at one table. For instance, for the career service, we have a working group with the general administration of the Max Planck Society, the PhDNet, and the Max Planck Alumni Association. And we then try to develop evidence-based services. Yeah. We also are in contact with political stakeholders, mainly on the federal level, because like many regulations are defined on this level. Like last year, there was a big amendment of the Wissenschaftszeitvertragsgesetz, which defines how long someone can be employed in time-limited contracts. And we are, of course, connecting with our friends, like Helmholtz Association. I just met them in July, and we have regular phone calls with them. Yeah, so, and then already a summary of this year career fair, which was surprisingly successful. And a big thank you to the organizing team that managed to do so. We could win again like 12 organizations to join our career fair. And as far as I heard, we had this time far more than 400 participants. we cannot always win all companies, but to join the career fair and pay a participation fee and so on. So that's why we also invited alumni, because these are the best to connect, yeah? Since they were facing the same challenges as our doctoral researchers are, and as Clemens did it quite nicely, for instance, in his talk, putting on his one slide the big questions you have to ask yourself and answer before you can continue your career. We also, as you might have seen yesterday, we had a professional photographer, and so we got really nice photos that we hopefully can share later on Facebook, so you can then mark yourself in the photos and so on. So, and then about the visions and science. So, this is like one of the main, so to say, business processes of the doctoral, of the PhDNet. And so, it's now the fifth time. And the idea behind the visions and science is, which I really like, to create a space where we can bring together all the doctoral researchers within the Max Planck Society, independent of the disciplines. Yeah, I mean, as you often might know, even the researcher next to you in the same office does so much different things than you do. And so it's quite challenging, how can you connect all these people? So in the visions and science propose the idea that, hey, let's not discuss so much about research details, but more about the future of science. Yeah? What are the visions? Where do we think science goes to? What could be maybe a research field I should learn more about because that will be my future research profile? And I think this works quite well. So, and also it contains another element, which is, I think, quite important to learn to communicate science. Yeah? In times where science gets more and more detailed, it's even more important that we keep the ability to communicate science to other researchers, but also to the public. And therefore, we kept this format of the Science Slam within the Visions in Science, which I really liked last year, because many of PhDNet active members were presenting their research, and I knew them before from working within the PhDNet, but I had just heard maybe that they're working at the Blend Breeding Research Institute, but I didn't really know what they are doing. But through the Science Slam, I first, for the first time, understood what their research is about. So this is really a nice format to communicate science. So, and as I was already talking about, so if you are affiliated with the Max Planck Society, really use this opportunity to apply for soft skill seminars. So there's still some budget left, so you can still organize this year soft skill seminars. And for instance, in Florence, they organized a really nice soft skill seminar where they learned to develop photographs. One of the soft enigmas I was already talking about, we had this big reform last year, so that now all the new doctoral researchers are employed via doctoral support contracts that allow them or that give them access also to the whole social insurance system. Yeah. So, and if you are interested in getting active in the PhDNet, then the general meeting is always the best place to do so. And this will take place this year in Berlin, not in Hanak House, more in the city center, and from November 9 to 11. And yeah, you can still register. We try to find like a short link. So this is a short link. Yeah, but you can also easily go just on phdnet.mpg.de and then click through Workgroup General Meeting and you will easily find it. I think there's even a short link on the main page. Yeah. So, and as you might have seen, there will be an unconference session after the session for all the ones that take not part in the guide, in the tour through the HANA course. And together with the scientific event group, I wrote a proposal for the Sharing Foundation, where we already discussed and developed new ideas where we can develop further the visions in science. That's why I called this topic also Future of Visions in Science. And so the Sharing Foundation proposed this funding scheme for society and science sessions. And they were in particular asking us, because the Visions in Science is like this nice platform for such a session, to write a proposal. And so we came up with the idea to get a bit back to the roots of the PhDNet, which is of more political, yeah, more based on this compensation guidelines, so that we also discuss about how can be science funded in the future. Yeah? As you might know, in particular on the European level, it's quite narrowed down what research fields are funded and which research fields are not. So what we want to do is we want to invite visionary thinkers in these three fields that give then a short input talk. Afterwards, we will have a panel discussion with the speakers, and then based on this input and these new ideas, the participants can organize their own sessions within a barcamp format, so they can propose then topics they want to deepen in the discussion. So, and the two other topics are citizen science, so this means the involvement of citizens in science projects, and I cited a paper in this proposal that where citizens handed in photos of their sunflowers and counted the seeds because they were doing research about the structure of these seeds within the flower. And as I was already talking about the Science Slam, knowledge transfer is one of the most important things because, as you know, science is often closed, so there's this big topic, open access, and so we also want to focus on this topic. Yeah. So, and if you are interested, for instance, organizing the Visions in Science next year or the career fair, this might be also a nice session to start this endeavor, and I will be happy to welcome you there. Yeah. So, and we are also here, the host, as half of the steering group and the whole scientific event group. So please also get back to us with feedback. What did you like about the career fair? What did you like about the Visions in Science? What didn't you like? And what would you like to see next year? It would be quite nice to get this feedback. So you can just talk to us. We are here. Okay, then thank you. So I wish you a nice conference. And yeah, I'm open for questions.
Sorry.
So no questions.
The conference session would.